Just yesterday, the one video was very viral on the social network, and then of the child in Gaza and Palestine, assuming maybe 5-6 years old, you can x-ray, you know, the how the things come in x-ray, you can x-ray the whole bones, the ribs, everything. And then I was talking to my own daughter who took the lunch to the school while the mother take a lot of time to get up early morning, prepare the lunch, and she brings it back as is. So we were just saying that to her. There are people, they don't have even that. You see that person died just because they not have. My question is to myself, first of all, to ourselves. Every day we sit with our family three times to eat. Those are lucky people. And even if not three times, at least one time we should be in our house eating together with our daughter, our parents, our children. So make sure you sound like a family. My respected brothers and sisters, many times we have many choices where to begin, where to end. To be understood that how great this blessing is. We don't have that varieties because I deserve it with due respect. We deserve it. Just because of the blessing it has been showered upon our soul. I personally see in our life, we cry a lot. We cry a lot for unnecessary things, small thing. While we have so much bounties, what Allah has blessed us into our life. Just 3-4 nights before, I was reading Facebook comments or the post, and this is what he says, subhanAllah, that risk, a risk, what we have sustained, what we call in general term, is not only to someone getting a per month 20, 30, 40, 50, 100K, even more based on the businessman who works as an employment, their income is limited. But mashallah, the businessman, he start from the $1,000, and there is some of a friend, they're making $250,000 a month, mashallah. God is great. So, my respected brother, the risk is not only to have a big numbers in the form of salary or the revenue, but the risk is also we have our parents and we have a good relations. We feel so honored. We're hearing their prayers. We have our wife. She's healthy. We have our children. There's no problem at all. Because just recently, someone among my circle who got the child and they called me, make dua that my child is having some difficulties. And then the person after himself saying that, wow, just asking Allah to have a child is one thing, but asking Allah to give something with siha, afiya, salama. So when we're asking Allah, Ya Allah, I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this. No, say, Ya Allah, if there is a khair, give me this. Or if we are eager to have that, say, Ya Allah, make this a khair for me and give it. Otherwise, at this moment, I just remember one painful story without identifying the background and nationality of a sister. You know, see, she had it 5 or 6 daughter in a row. Sometime, to respect Indian, Pakistani culture, we have a jihala at the back home. I don't know about other because I belong to that land. So that's why it's easier for me to narrate that. We look for the boys. Come on. Has nothing to do in Islam, the boys and the girl, but unfortunately that disease is when the girls comes to after the marriage to the boy house, the mother-in-law, what are you having? Is the boy? Come on, why you don't say that as a girl? Seeing that as a witness, that's why when I had a daughter, I had the daughter, alhamdulillah, I have a 4 daughter. I have spent it to serve the sweet to the community more than $5,500. The much sweet I have bought it from the sweet mart. They were saying, you're having a boy? I was like, why? Because the sweet you're buying. I said, because I have to break that tradition of a jihad. And I'm saying very honestly, friendly and frank. When I got after 4 daughter, I one son, I give nothing. Because I have to go against of jihala, all is nam. So there's nothing, alhamdulillah, other than this was aqiqa, which was a sunnah more than that. So the sister who had the 6 daughter, being as a human being, person, sometimes get frustrated. As in a frustration, there's a 2 narrations is, remember that when Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam passed away, one companion, he was picking some date from the palm tree, and when he got to know Anna Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Qadama, he says, there's no joy in this world. What I'm going to see this beautiful world anymore? If the beauty of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam cannot be seen from this eye, I don't want this eyes, Ya Rab. You know what happened? Allah accepted the dua and the eyesight was taken before even he came down. That was his level of faith and belief. Subhanallah. Second is, this is to say that the prayers can be accepted any time. So that shows the love of Sahaba and Sahabiyat in regards to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But then the sister, when she was praying, exhausted and tensioned between her situation, she said, made the dua. Ya Allah, just give me some boy, whether it's a leg broken, head broken, eyes, blinds, whatever. You know what happened? A witness person standing here, very panic and very painful. May Allah protect us all who have a child. May Allah make them, keep them healthy, wealthy, bisiha and afia. Who are married or didn't have a child, may Allah give them afia, bisalama, healthy, wealthy child. The child, boom, had no eyes, ears, this. And now she had to regret, and she was disclosed that this is the result of my dua.